With economic growth and globalization taking over the world, there are debates on how to improve the quality of education in schools. Education programs should focus on bettering the student achievements. But the traditional education systems are not capable of providing the students with necessary knowledge and skills, as well as fulfilling the performance expectations. If the system can provide three main skills of creative thinking, the ability to find new solutions for existing problems, and flexible mind, then it would be beneficial for children in the future. It is quite possible to create innovative strategies, so to improve the minds of kids. Here are the 10 ways to improve the education quality in schools. Welcome to The Ardent Blogger, a channel for all the curiosity lovers who want to know something different every day. Today, we are back with an amazing video. If you have not subscribed to the channel, you are missing out a lot. Number 1. Normally, schools have been using ordinary models, where the students are required to give a direct answer for the question asked by their teachers. In a possible environment, the teacher must encourage kids to find the right answer to the question on their own. This will help them to develop imagination, observing and reasoning. Number 2. In the traditional education system, the teacher leads the progress of a lesson without giving kids any possibility to discover things on their own. We believe that the teacher should give some space for kids to study new things and observe the entire process of studying to give some help whenever needed. It becomes extremely important to give students some independence and possibility to develop their minds on their own. Number 3. We all used to see children sitting in a traditional classroom at their usual desks. This setup teaches them some discipline. However, this method better fits on a system where the teacher is the leader and children had to follow him or her. Some development should be made where kids should sit at a round table. This will make the atmosphere interactive, where the students can share their opinions and listen to the others as well. Number 4. The existing learning methods certainly depend on a lot of different ideas and projects. However, the learning should be done on the basis of the student's ability to combine the knowledge in just the one project, without separating things into smaller parts. This will help them develop a creative mind and analytical skills, which altogether comprises to form good logical ability. Number 5. This method defines each of the ideas that are considered for a school student as a unique project. Adopting some innovation system, where kids learn to invent something new and seek for unusual solutions for different types of problems. It will help them to improve on a creativity level and will motivate the students to make new ideas and projects in the future. Number 6. Such kind of methods certainly helps the students to develop their creativity. Usually, such tools are based on brainstorming and discussing things in the groups. There are many methods based on the children's age, where the teachers can inculcate the habits of brainstorming. It can be through games, puzzles or other techniques. Number 7. There can be two directions for solving different problems. First one is problem to solution, which helps to find the optimal solutions after understanding the problem. While the other is solution to problem, where the children should seek a solution to the non-existent problem. As these two methods allows children to think about the problem with various perspectives, this is why the system has to be followed. Number 8. Traditional education programs requires everybody to move from one lesson to the other. However, children should link previously studied things with the new. There should be some systems or techniques developed for linking the previous studied experience and knowledge with the information studied on new lessons. This will help the students to get the ability of critical thinking and using the concepts in higher problems properly. Number 9. Assessment should be expanded beyond simple test scores. It should provide a detailed continuous profile of a student where they can highlight their strengths and weaknesses. This way, your teachers, parents, and individual students can closely monitor the academic progress and use the assessment to focus on areas that needs improvement. Tests should serve as the opportunity for the students to learn from their mistakes and improve their scores. Number 10. Partnerships with a wide range of community organizations, including business, higher education, and government agencies, can really prove to be significant in providing critically needed materials, technology, and experiences for students and teachers. These groups tend to expose the students and teachers to the world of work through school-to-career programs and internships. We are glad you have made till the end. We have handpicked the videos which we recommend you watch next. Feel free to talk to us on our social media channels or on our website, theardentblogger.com, about any recommendations or suggestions.